King Solomon, renowned for his boundless wisdom and sagacity, is a tableau vivant of opulence, political intrigue, and intimate domestic dramas. Within the gilded halls of Jerusalem, an extraordinary dinner unfolds, a banquet that would subtly precipitate the fragmentation of a kingdom that had, under Solomon's rule, experienced unprecedented prosperity and peace. This is not merely a story about the gastronomical choices of an ancient king, but a profound narrative that explores how the desires and petitions of his numerous wives wove the fabric of his destiny, ultimately leading to a crucial, nation-altering decision. The evening was soft with the whispers of the cooling breeze that swept through the corridors of Solomon's majestic palace. Outside, the Jerusalem skyline was a silhouette against the settling dusk, a crown upon the mighty kingdom of Israel. Inside, the grand dining hall glimmered with the light of 1,000 candles, their flames dancing on walls adorned with intricate tapestries, depicting scenes of Solomon's ascension and Israel's glory.
As the distinguished guests began to arrive, among them were Solomon's wives, each representing different alliances and each bearing the cultural heritage of her homeland. Their diverse backgrounds were not merely a testament to Solomon's extensive political reach, but also to the myriad influences they brought to bear on his decision-making. Among these influential spouses were Pharaoh's daughter, who was steadfast in promoting an alliance with Egypt, and Naamah the Ammonite, who yearned for the greater recognition of her people. The banquet served not only as a venue for displaying Solomon's culinary largesse, but also as an arena where the subtle battle for influence was waged. Each wife hoped her favorite dish might find favor in the eyes of the king, thereby tipping his decisions toward her homeland. Amidst this culinary diplomacy, Solomon's proverbial wisdom was his only ally, aiding him in navigating the treacherous waters of domestic and international politics.
The highlight of the evening was the presentation of the main dish, a splendid creation known as the King's Delight. This particular meal had been suggested by one of Solomon's lesser-known wives, who argued that its ingredients symbolized unity and strength, qualities she felt were slipping from Solomon's grasp as his reign became increasingly burdened by competing interests.
The King's Delight was a culinary metaphor crafted to influence the king's thoughts toward greater unity among his disparate wives, and by extension, the territories they represented. It contained ingredients from every region under Solomon's rule: wheat from the plains of Judah, olives from Samaria, fish from the Mediterranean, and spices sourced from the farther reaches of the empire. This dish was not just a feast for the senses. It was a strategic move cloaked in the finery of hospitality. As the dish was served, murmurs of admiration echoed around the opulent dining hall. It was then that Solomon, surrounded by his wives, understood the full implication of the meal placed before him. Each bite was a reminder of the complexity of his empire and the interconnectedness of his household. In Solomon's heart and mind, the symphony of flavors melded into a revelation, an understanding that his governance needed a more holistic approach, integrating the diverse cultures and interests of his people.
Solomon's realization at the dinner sparked a period of introspection. Although it is said that Solomon continued to exhibit a semblance of wise governance, the story of the banquet and the King's Delight underscores the profound impact of personal relationships on political power. The king's judgment remained astute, but as with all human tales, his decisions bore the indelible marks of the influences around him, especially those at his table. Solomon's well-intentioned efforts to please and unify his kingdom through personal diplomacy at his domestic dinner table metaphorically mirrored his diplomatic strategies on the wider geopolitical stage. However, the tensions among his wives and the competing interests they brought to the royal table foreshadowed the eventual fracturing of his kingdom into the northern and southern regions after his reign. King Solomon's story serves not only as a testament to his legendary wisdom, but also as a cautionary tale about the pervasive power of intimate and interpersonal dynamics within the halls of power. His dinner dilemma, while seemingly trivial, was a consequential pivot around which the fate of an entire kingdom turned, highlighting that even the wisest of rulers must tread carefully among the desires and designs of those closest to them.